we have nothing before us. These words from Charles Dickens could accurately portray the last 14 months of our lives. This was not our ideal senior year, and with our limited capacity, this is not our ideal graduation. But we are still graduating. We are wrapping up this chapter of our lives and beginning a new one. All of our sleepless nights, quiet hours of studying, and stress have not gone unnoticed. We are dedicated, determined, and committed. Nothing will stand in the way of the Bishop Walsh class of 2021. This evening, I am not saying goodbye to just a school. I am saying goodbye to the place that has provided me with an exceptional education. I am saying goodbye to the hallways that I wish I could stay in forever. I am saying goodbye to the place that has taught me it is okay to be exactly who you are. And I am saying goodbye to the people who have shaped me, inspired me, into whom I am so much. Looking at the group of people who have shown me what it's like to know true kindness, I can't help but feel a sense of pride. I am so blessed to be a part of such an intelligent and talented group of students. Although my time at Bishop Walsh was short, I will never be able to say thank you enough. Thank you to my fellow classmates, teachers, and all of the faculty and staff. Going into school each day felt like walking into a building full of family. And while some of us are staying in the area, others are living across the globe. No matter where we are or what we are doing, we will forever share such a beautiful moment. To the Bishop Walsh class of 2021, thank you for making each struggle a little less scary, each joy a little better, and each day a little brighter. These past 3 years have been so memorable that it makes saying goodbye so utterly and impossibly hard. So before we say goodbye tonight, let us reflect on where we have been and where we are going. Thank you and welcome.
Good evening, everyone. We welcome you all, and we're pleased to have with us on this special day Deacon Christopher Young, who is our delegate to the Archbishop, and he's here with us this evening representing the Archbishop and all those at the Catholic Center, because it's an important day for you guys. You've been through a lot, you know, and this is really special. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, be with you. You better prepare ourselves to receive our Lord and to encounter him in this Eucharist. Let us begin by asking forgiveness for our sins.
You were sent to heal a contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Let us pray. O God, the Father of your gift, we confess that all we have and all we are comes down from you. Teach us to recognize the effects of your boundless care, and to love you with a sincere heart and with all our strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Let us be seated for our readings from the Scripture. Let us stand as we prepare to do the gospel of the Lord.
Don't give anyone a reason. not live by. This is what he's telling Timothy. So he's telling Timothy, focus on what you were called to be. That I laid hands upon you, and now you are
a bishop.
But don't think you're entitled to respect just because you're a bishop and commitment to do it. And live it by example. Be a man of integrity. So that when people come to you, they can't argue with you. They can't have a word against you. So the question is, what are the most important lessons you may have learned from your journey? And I'm going to give you the journey part, because that's a part of the deal. What is the most important lesson you may have learned out of your own road? You learned a lot. What is the most important lesson? Respect one for their dignity. And what else do you want? Good, don't take it in the ground. Don't take it in the issues in the ground. St. Paul is telling Timothy, don't take the gift you receive in the ground. Everyone heard this letter at the same time in a place like this in the Mass. reach out and reach this. Respond to all to men, not being modest. Respond to all about to men, being respectful to your family. Respond to all about all the virtues, to caring, to your all the destiny, your all the journey. And Paul is saying this in front of everyone, so he's holding Timothy accountable. And he's saying, Timothy can't go, Timothy's strengthened Timothy now, because no one can say to Timothy, Paul didn't say that. Paul didn't say that. So they can't ever have contempt for him.
Yes, he did.
He's already in the Bible. So he, Paul, advised to make sure that the whole body is living with Paul and your family. This is new because you are, this is something that will bond you forever. Yes, you'll be going on a journey. There's some new lives, but I think you have some tight bonds, don't you? You have some tight friendships here, don't you? I think you're going to be bonding. You can check up on your friends. Living in God's all the principles that we learned in school? You struggling with them? And I'm struggling with them, man. I need some help. I need some help to live. That you can help one another on this journey. That you, and when you're not with one another, you can pray. I'm about to ask for a record of my old pastors. Ask for a record. I hope you do the same with one another. That you support one another.
Great coming back to the time of the empire, Stephen Ray.
Great Commission. It tells a story of the decline. It tells a story of a man who went to heaven, who died. He finally got to the gates, got to the real gates. And without getting him in here, and he's oh, so excited that they didn't have to hear. Go to heaven. And he's like, hey, this rules this deal. In order to pass this gate, I have to go out of life. And I want them to know the things you've done, when you qualify for you to come in here. Now, for everything you do, there's points. You have to score 100 points. So the man's like, oh, yes. Well, so you hear, I've been married to the same woman for 50 years. And I've never been unfaithful to her. I'm faithful, never been looked at alone. He goes to the heavenly computer. Ooh, that's pretty good. That's worth 3 points. 3 points? What? Well, St. Peter, my wife and I, used to tithe. In fact, before any taxes, we gave 20% of our money to the church and to help people, help the poor prisoners. And it goes to the heavenly computer. Ooh, that's pretty good. That's 2 points. She starts scratching his head. This is looking too good. All right, second year. For 20 years, my wife and I, we actually started a soup kitchen. We've been in for 20 years. And we didn't ask for a dime. He goes to heaven to the computer. Not bad, that's what I'm wondering. And the man is frustrated. Oh, it looks like I'm never going to get in heaven except by the grace of God. 100 points rating. The Lord wants to give you the grace you need. The journey. He's going to give you all the success, all those tools. Focus on the journey so that your life is one of integrity. No matter what you do, you say that as a child of God.
And now this is more believe us. Prayer to the faithful. Let us pray.
We come together this evening to celebrate.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for hearing and answering these prayers through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Let us continue to prepare the altar.
The blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out.
for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. A mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, and our Savior, who have been led through his passion to the death of the cross, to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again and offers you the bread of life. But with the favor of the relation of your church, in which we show forth the past sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and granted by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am our
Donna Joyce. The Excellence in Mathematics Award is presented to Nestor Diachon. The Amen Memorial Award for a student who has continuously worked to improve his or her academics and has succeeded is presented to Emily Eisenhower. The Medal for Excellence in Physical Education is presented to Davi Botelho. The Leo Lai Award is presented to Grace Barringer. The Medal for Excellence in Art, as well as the Medals for Christian Values and Lifestyles, and the Bishop Walsh Exemplary Female Student are all presented to Karina Falter. The Excellence in Performing Arts and the fifth highest average for 4 years medals are presented to Corinne Donaway.
Good evening, and congratulations to my fellow graduates. The word graduate So it seems fitting that this important milestone is just one step in our journey that began a long time ago. Tonight also marks the moment where the path we've been traveling together will split into 34 unique roads. Until now, we have been traveling this road as one, as the class of 2021. Let us retrace this journey by remembering where it all began. For some of us, that day occurred 14 years ago, on our first day of pre-K at Bishop Walsh. Throughout elementary and middle school, we were always one of the smallest groups of students. However, it was not until our freshman year of high school that our class started to substantially increase in size as we graciously welcomed new members. That year, we found ourselves navigating the hallways as young teens, while juggling academic demands and balancing extracurricular activities and practices. The importance of our faith in God and the values of respect and discipline were emphasized on a daily basis and paved the way for our success, both academically and spiritually. Our sophomore year was a time of change with the addition of the elite basketball program. It sparked a new sense of enthusiasm and excitement on Haystack Mountain while expanding the Bishop Walsh family even further, both nationally and internationally. That year also provided new challenges as our focus became clear and we started to realize that good grades and performances actually counted for something and were important for future goals. That year, the path leading into our junior year began rather smoothly with the newfound independence and drive. As much as we practiced and improved our driving skills, there was no driver's education course that could have prepared us for the largest road bump on our journey, the coronavirus. Thursday, March 12, 2020, began as a normal day. However, we soon learned that we would be pivoting to a virtual learning platform for 2 weeks. Students and teachers alike were scrambling to adapt to this new method of education. Unfortunately, 2 weeks of virtual learning turned into the remainder of our junior year. As our senior year was about to commence, we quickly realized that it would not be what we had envisioned. Although we were lucky enough to begin this momentous year in person, we still struggled with shortened sports seasons, the loss of homecoming, and other extracurricular activities being canceled or shifted to a completely digital platform. As area code numbers began to rise in November, we found ourselves sitting at home again in front of our computers. We adapted and we persevered, and after the start of the new year, we were able to return to the building. On behalf of the class of 2021, I would like to thank the amazing teachers and dedicated staff for their efforts in making this transition easier and maintaining some form of normalcy. To our families, thank you for the love, support, and encouragement during these unprecedented times. Despite the challenges and disappointments, we are blessed in so many aspects of our lives. This class has certainly made history on Haystack Mountain. We saw it each day as we walked down the halls. We saw it in the works of art displayed throughout the school. We saw the achievements in sports posted in the local paper. We saw the academic success through the hard work and dedication of students in the classroom. We should be proud of what we have all achieved on our journey through high school. The road we have been traveling brings us together to celebrate tonight. And this is the part of our journey where we should stop, take a moment, and reflect on what has been accomplished. What we have done together over the past few years is truly outstanding. We stuck together and grew together, and I could not have chosen a better class to be part of. I have faith in each and every one of you that no matter which path you choose to travel, you will make it your own, and you will succeed. So, my friends, remember to relax, grow stronger, and let God share your love. This is not the end or goodbye forever. This is just one step closer to our own unique Splendid Road. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Having fulfilled the requirements for graduation from Bishop Walsh School, Patrick Ryan.